Hey guys, here I am again with another video. I'm still going strong and sticking to my upload schedule of one video a week. I must say that this video is kind of pushing it since I'm making it on the day that it's supposed to be uploaded, but I hope I can get back on track and make my videos ahead again for the next couple of weeks. I've really come to realize that I really enjoy working with traditional medium, and every time I'm working on digital medium for a longer period, I find that I don't enjoy it as much. So I'm not going to do that a lot anymore, I think. But I do still want to use digital medium to add details and to edit my work, and I think there's a lot of strength in combining those two. In this video, I'm going to show you how I paint these fantasy bird-like creatures. I'm doing them all in the same color scheme to make them more as a set. The beginning idea was to make a repeatable pattern design, but now I actually finished the birds. I think they're a little bit too complicated, too distracting from each other to use them together in a pattern design. But I do want to use them for maybe stickers and individual designs for merch. I'll have to look which ones I like and if they're usable for merch. So last week I did a lot of work in my sketchbook, and I actually almost finished an entire sketchbook that week. And although it was a lot of fun, it also hurt my wrist a bit. And I'm really noticing these things where some art that I do really hurts my wrist, and then some art that I do doesn't really hurt my wrist. So what I noticed is that actually digital art working on my iPad is really, really bad for my wrist, and I don't know why that is. Maybe I grabbed my Apple Pencil in the wrong way. Also, I find it really uncomfortable if the iPad warms up and I have to draw on a warm surface. But yeah, I don't know. I feel like that even if it's traditional, drawing just hurts my wrist a lot more than painting this. So I want to try and see if I can make a healthy mix-up of when I do painting and when I do drawing, so I take a lot of pressure off my wrist. And another thing that I think really hurts my wrist is actually gaming. And I know that a lot of artists of my age really, really like to game too, and of course we really enjoy the art of the games. But yeah, maybe that's something that I really want to cut back on personally. If you're having wrist pains yourself as an artist and you're also a gamer, maybe that's something you can cut back on to relieve the pain in your hands a bit. And definitely if you are one of these artists that has wrist pains and you have some things that help for you, it would be great if you would let me know, so I could maybe use it and help myself a bit. Yeah, that would be great. So a little bit about the painting. I am painting more with my tubes, watercolor tubes at the moment. I noticed that I used my pens a lot, and that my tubes were just laying in a box, and I only used them when I had to refill a pen. And that's kind of sad, because I have a lot of tubes that are not part of my custom palettes, and I do want to use them too, because they're great paint. And so what I am doing now more often is I make a beginning palette, small palette, with a little bit of fresh paint out of the tubes. And then every color variation that I make, or if I make switches in the colors, I use my pens to add some paint to switch the color up a little bit. And that way I can use more of my different paints too. So the colors I started with, the first one is a paint of my Jello Mission Gold. It's the brilliant pink, and I watered it down a ton, and I used some red that was in my palette to mix some transparent paint in it. So the brilliant pink is not really a transparent paint, and I wanted to make it slightly opaque. Yeah, I think these two colors combined works really well for the pink skin of the birch. The blue I used actually is a turquoise blue deep of Old Holland, and I mixed it up with a little bit of Sennelier Phthalo Green Deep. And as I already told you, I made slight color shifts with paints that were already in my palette, so I don't actually know which ones those were. I think I'll be using this way of using paints a lot more after this, because I think it also really helps me to stick to a certain color palette and maybe choose a different color palette that I usually pick. I think this pink with blue looks really, really good, and I don't think that it's something that I normally would pick. So yeah, I think that really helped me. And definitely when you're always using the same palette with all the different colors that you can pick, it's just so easy to pick your favorite colors and only use those favorite colors in every single painting that you make. So I don't think that separating sometimes a little bit from those colors is a bad thing. I think you learn a lot when using different colors. I picked the subject of birch to draw today because it's kind of a comfort zone for me, and I wanted to just relax and have fun, and I also wanted to play a little bit with some fantasy aspects, because I think I always have drawn birds like realistically, and now I wanted to see if I could change up their designs and see if I could change the form of the wings and add these flower things that I did on the tails and such. So yeah, just play with it. And I think it's also a great practice for if I want to draw more winged creature designs in the future, or maybe winged character designs, then of course birds is always a good thing to practice for that. And because I was thinking about making this into a pattern, I wanted to paint some little things to fill up white space in the pattern, and I decided to paint some cute blueberries in the blue that I was working with, and I wanted to make some random leaves in the pink. So yeah, that's what you can see me doing now on the screen. I think one of the problems that I still have with pattern designs is that I want to make every single part of the pattern too difficult, and that I overwork things. So yeah, I'll probably try to make simpler designs real soon. Another thing that I wanted to talk about in this video is I wanted to let you guys know a little bit more about me. I wanted to try and talk a little bit more about myself in these videos, because I thought it would be fun to know each other a little bit more. I always love hearing about other artists' life when I watch videos, but I never know what to talk about my life, because I don't think that my life is all that interesting. I just sit every day in my room and I paint and I draw, and that's what I do. I launched my webshop a couple of weeks ago, and I sold a couple of things, so that's what I'm really happy about. Of course, it's not enough to live off yet, but it's a great improvement from what I had before. So yeah, that's something that has been really positive in my life lately. I've also heard back from all the conventions that I was going to do that were cancelled, and they have been rescheduled, so they haven't been totally cancelled, so I'm really excited to be doing my first convention. I think it's the 4th and 5th of July. I'll have to look it up, and I'll tell you guys more about it on my Instagram and in upcoming videos probably too. I honestly have no idea where to start with which things that I have to take to the convention. I think it's partly just some trial and error, and make some merchandise and take it with me and see what works and what doesn't work. Since it's art, it's all subjective, so I don't think there's a way to know in advance which pieces will sell and which pieces won't sell. Actually, these birds that I'm painting right now is a great example, because I really like some of the birds that I did, but then I don't like some of the others, and turns out that everyone's favorite is one of the ones that I actually don't like. And yeah, that's a great example when you don't know what's going to sell, because your taste will be different than other people's taste. For my convention, I think I will mainly focus on making those custom sketchbooks that I've been selling on my webshop. Those have been doing really, really well, and they're fun and not that difficult to make. So yeah, I think that's something that I'm going to do. I don't know if I'll be able to order more stickers, because they're kind of an investment. But if I have some really cute designs, or if there are some designs that you guys think I really should put into a sticker design, then I'll probably make some more. I've been really enjoying the quality of the Sticker App stickers that I've been ordering. And with that, we're almost at the end of the video. I hope you've enjoyed looking at me painting these birds. And I'll try to be a bit earlier with making the video for next week. And I hope I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!